Oh, it's you.
I got his letter.
Mr. Arthur.
Sir?
Education is the most wonderful thing. It'll raise us higher and higher. make civics and ethics less a work of dirty-minded pragmatists like me, and the calling of higher, better men.
Hear, hear.
Without it, we are savages. But with learning, why, in 50 years, man will put down his guns and start living a life of relentless purity.
Hear, hear.
But the rich can be so very self-absorbed.
How can I help?
You can't.
We need all our strengths. That's the point. We've gone over this.
Violence is never right.
I agree with you. But it's not violence. It's the mere threat of violence.
Against whom?
Oh. Against Hector Fellow's worst nature. To convince him to make good on his promise to help finance the library.
Who is he and where do I find him?
He's a newspaper man. And he's...
He's leaving town on a coach, heading to his country estate, because he doesn't like your heavy-handed approach.
Well, he certainly won't like my heavy-handed approach.
Thank you, Mr. Arthur.
You'll spot him on the road through the bayou. He has a red coach. So we are clear. I do not approve of this behavior.
Okay, boy. Passenger a moment. Okay, drive.
What the hell do you want?
Mr. Fellows, ain't it? Charity, sir. And an appeal to your better nature.
This is most impudent.
Oh, no, it's not most impudent. Trust me, buddy. I can get a whole lot more impudent. But this is a good cause for a wealthy man such as yourself. The chance to add some dignity to all that wealth.
Dignity?
By helping to finance a library in town. Think of the prestige, sir.
Oh, get out of my carriage.
But the mayor...
The mayor? The mayor is a crook.
Me too. And I'm a real crook.
I will not be bullied by you, sir. Get out of here!
Ah! Oh, I'm sorry, was that? Yes, I'd like to finance the library for the common good. Ah! I didn't hear you. See? That wasn't difficult. You know, they say it's better to give than to receive. And certainly in the case of a beating, I know that's true. Now, the mayor awaits your check, sir. Been a pleasure. There's a good man in there. Let him live a little more. Driver! Hold up! As you were. Come on! Yeah. Yep.
Hey, partner.
Welcome back. What you need to send? This'll get where it needs to. You have a good one.
Yeah.
All right, boy.
Out of the damn way!
There you are. Come on, keep walking. You're late.
Well, the days in this place you turned into some clock-watching city boy. What's the urgency?
We need to leave. Forever. We've been doing well, making money. But for us all to leave together, we need enough for a boat. Now, I found a friendly ship captain. He's willing to take us to Australia or Tahiti. We just need to pay for passage and give him money for land when we get there. No questions asked. We will disappear, be reborn.
Well, where the hell is Tahiti?
South Pacific, an untouched paradise.
Who lives there?
Tahitians, I guess.
We made a bit of money on that riverboat job, but not enough for us to leave and live peacefully. Where's the rest coming from?
In there.
So we are gonna rob that place?
Well, I didn't think we was fixing the plumbing. I don't know if you have noticed, but we are on the clock. I reckon we got a few days before the Pinkertons show, and then, well, we're done. Now, we need money. Bronte said this place has got money. Come on!
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a robbery. Behave as I tell you, and none of you will die. Annoy me, and you all will. Now remember, we just want money. Don't make us kill you. Mr. M, leave these.
Come now, why are you doing this?
They're valuable. Mr. S, check that room back there. I got this one. Dying.
That's your choice, not mine. Kindly open that gate. Let my acquaintance inside.
Now, I'm gonna need everything you got on you.
Okay.
I said, fine,
it's yours.
And let my acquaintance. Yeah, of course.
There's nothing much here. There's nothing really here.
You're sure?
Yes.
Then get out here and get ready for company. All of you! Behave. We don't want to hurt any of you. Mr. M, check the safe.
Sure.
I don't think they keep much cash in there.
Open it! Ah! There's almost nothing here.
There should be stacks of cash in there. He told us there was. Look again.
There's no stacks. A few dollars in coins. That's it. Damn!
We got a problem. There's a ton of cops out there.
Come on now! We got you surrounded!
That greasy son of a bitch! He set us up!
You think?
This seemed like a good time for sarcasm to you, Arthur.
What are we gonna do, gentlemen?
Something! The trolley. The trolley! Follow me, gentlemen! Go! Woo! Now!
Go! Does this trolley go to Tahiti?
I hope so! Hold them off, fellas! Look out on the right! We got some in those alleyways, Arthur!
End up on that balcony! Some riders coming on this side!
Arthur, cover our left! Let it! You all right there, kid?
I'm good!
Got a hit!
Arthur, coming out of the fence! To the right! That bastard must have called in every cop in the city! Outside the saloon! Oh, damn! We are really moving here! Arthur, slow us down! Slow this thing down!
I'll try!
Things broke.
Hold on!
Thank you.
Let's
get us out of here.
I think we're clear.
You know what, Dutch? Next time, let's not damn discretion.
Seemed like a good lead.
I know, but...
Well, we made it. Thanks to you.
Don't mention it.
Yeah.
You're a good kid.
And we each got $15. Oh, and a quarter. Don't forget the quarter.
Shut up, Arthur. He set us up. Played me like a yokel. Put the law on us. What did we do to him? What did I do to him?
I guess he thinks he's the king around here. He don't want the likes of you. So, what are we doing next, Dutch?
We just need money. One more decent take, and we're gone. The bank is our bet. Hosea agrees.
Even after that?
Especially after that. I don't feel so good.
Now you just got a bash on the head.
Come on. I'm taking you back to camp.
Hey, you did real good there, Lenny. Just wish it could have turned out better.
Well, can't win them all.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.